artichokes were one of my first interests as a person with interest in horticulture. And I've been growing them for about 35 years, ever since I saw an article that said you can't grow them here in Colorado. So that was a put down, and yes, you can grow artichokes in Colorado. So these are artichokes, globe artichokes, the kind you'll buy at a store. And what you harvest with globe artichokes is the immature bud of the flower when it comes out. These ones here are a little past harvest. This is late in the year, and these are fairly small plants, but typically I'll get two big ones, about five medium-sized ones, and then lots of little ones, and they're all delicious. This can only be grown as an annual here in Colorado. If the temperatures get below 20 during winter, the roots get killed, so you have to, I start them every year about March 1st, and then plant them out after frost. So we've got a couple different varieties. Some of them will flowered a little too early this year, so the plant didn't get big. Some of them, like some of the ones in the back, took a little longer, and we've got a bigger plant, we'll get more yield. This is what I like to see in Colorado. This is what we normally get for most of them. And again, you can get multiple buds. All of these, again, are too past. Once they start to come out a little flaring like that, they're starting to turn into a flower. The flower, though, is great. I'm keeping these for flowers. There'll be a big, giant thistle flower that dries well and looks really great. So this is probably the most advanced artichoke flower we have now. But if we take this into the end of December, lots of these will all be beautiful open flowers. With the this hasn't opened yet, but it's coming there. Anyway, I like it both as an interesting vegetable, which I love, and I like the flowers late in the year, the ones I don't pick and let go. So this plant is a relative of artichokes. It's called cardoon. You'll find it grown in the Mediterranean area, particularly around Italy. And instead of using the buds, you have to use the base of the stalk. So the base here, I didn't break it off very well, but then you just cook it. You steam it or whatever, and it has an artichoke taste. So these are true artichoke family plants. These are thistles. So in this little area here, I'm trialing different kinds of herbs that I've seen in different parts of the world that I want to see if I can grow them here in Colorado. And the first one is the plant that is both illustrated here and here, two different varieties. It's called toothache plant, paracress, buzz buttons, electric daisy, whatever. It has interesting effects if you ingest either the leaves or the little buds. I'll take a little bud here. And about 20 seconds later, increases salivation, gives a little tingling of the mouth, and it's used to just infuse stews to make them more interesting. I first saw this in Madagascar, where it's part of their national dish called Roma Sava, but it can be used in lots of things. This is a more ornamental variety. That's the wild type, originally from South America. My mouth is really zinging. It lasts about 4 or 5 minutes. Anyway, yeah, it's quite a plant. So I think these would make a really good plant in the garden as an accent plant, and also one that you can eat. So this is a section of one of the herbs. These are just different kinds of basil. And the thing I think is most interesting that I wanted to plant this year are kinds of basil that have that resist flowering. So these are called emerald towers or tall towers, depending on the variety. So this is your standard Genovese type of basil that everybody normally grows. But this is the emerald towers version of it. And it doesn't flower for about 15 weeks later, and still hasn't flowered. Taste is slightly different, but pretty good. Pretty similar. And then this is a parallel series for a Thai basil. So this is a good variety of Thai basil, and this is the Thai tall towers. So the herb here that I'm interested in is one of several I've seen in Mexico. This is chia, and chia is a seed that has been grown for thousands of years. It was a main staple crop of the Mayans. It has numerous nutrient effects, and it's used in lots of foods.
But I wanted to see if I could grow it here. And I did grow one variety. I've grown this variety that I got from the seed catalog. And this is not flowering yet. As it turns out, chia is a plant that needs short days in order to flower. However, the University of Kentucky did a development project to create a chia that would flower early, and they now sell it as heartland chia. And I just planted some of these seeds, and these plants are fantastic in terms of value in a garden for pollinators. I mean, these are now past their prime. These ones in the front, I did de-head them, but these were covered with the bees and then later butterflies. This is a salvia, and salvia are well known. We've got lots of salvia that we grow in our gardens here in Colorado that are ornamentals, but this is an ornamental, plus you'll get chia seed from it. The seed from this will come from one of these stalks. You take this, and I don't think there's much that is yet mature. There's a few seeds in here. Anyway, I would let this go dry, completely dry, and then thresh it. And I'm just gonna break it up and the seeds will fall out. But we're getting seeds, but they're not, this is still too early to harvest this. So another plant that's very widely used in Mexico that I was trying to see if we could grow well here is called epazote. It's used in cooking for many things. It gives an interesting flavor to many dishes. Also has the effect, allegedly, of reducing farting. So it's used a lot in beans, mixed with beans to reduce farting. But anyway, epazote is a plant that grows very well here. And it is normally green. This is a kind of more ornamental looking purple variety. It doesn't yield as well. These are past the point when I would use them for the leaves. Down here are small plants that are recently transplanted, and this is what you would harvest more, the leaves that on this, rather than this fully mature plant that was been out here for months. But epazote grows really well here. It has a really tiny seed, so you just have to sprinkle it on the top. You can't bury it very deeply, and it will reseed some in the garden if you have those conditions. Now over here is another plant that I see in the markets in Oaxaca very commonly. It's called chepiche or papiche, and you use the leaves for this. It is used in many dishes. It has a very interesting flavor. Some people consider it to be sort of like cilantro, or call it cilantro on steroids, because it has cilantro flavors that are a little more intense. But anyway, it has a lot of dishes, is used in a lot of dishes, and again, something like this, you know, might be sold in a market, maybe half of this in a batch, and I'd see that very commonly in the markets down there. Anyway, I just think this is another herb that does grow here, and can be used in making dishes a little more interesting.